Okay, welcome back to Go Bonsai Live. I'm James. Thanks for stopping by. If you can't hear me, comment in the chats below. So thanks for stopping by. Thanks for subscribing. Really appreciate all the new subs. We got the echo here. All right. Now I'm trying something new. So I guess I can hear myself. So I'll be able to monitor the video from my tablet while I stream on my phone, and we'll see if this stream looks better in rotation from the other side of my camera. We'll give that a shot right now. And not really that much better, but hook it up down here. Okay. Excuse me. So yeah, it doesn't look too much better, but at least I can monitor it without having to look at the phone. Maybe I can see what's going on. Let's see. I can make a comment. Say go bonsai if y'all have any questions or comments. Make sure to leave them in the chat section. And we'll make some happy bonsai today. So we're gonna prepare. Send that off. Okay, that worked. We're going to prepare to make bonsai. What we have here is a tree, a redwood tree. It is a Aptos blue type tree, type redwood. And it's in a plastic pot. The branches aren't developed and the roots aren't really fully developed either. So, or the nabari, the spread at the base of the tree, the root spread. But we're not going to make it a bonsai today. We're just going to prepare to make it a bonsai. So it's pre-bonsai. I just want to repot it, check the roots out, clean it up, and maybe cut some of these unnecessary branches. So put my gloves on. We'll get started. See, these roots are so fully root bound in this pot, so we'll untangle those. Massage it out, loosen it up. Shake. I'll clean this moss off the base here. So yeah, if it looks bad, let me know. If it sounds bad, let me know. Don't be shy. And if you have any questions, let me know. There's no bad questions. Any question is going to lead you to being better at your craft, or some like to say a bonsai master. Or, as the bonsai masters will say, bonsai master, bonsai, not bonsai, bonsai. But I say bonsai because I'm from Louisiana, and we say things how we want, you know, American way. I just don't have the Japanese accent, you know. It's hard for me to add that distinction unconsciously. So I'll say it consciously, but not unconsciously. But, if you can understand how that works. So we're just taking the chopstick here and knocking it loose, knocking these roots free. We're gonna untangle them and clean them and prune them, the ones that are too long, so we can ramify the roots. We want the roots to be tight and hair-like and growing around in a nice 360 degree radius around the trunk. Look at these long roots. Just cut these off. Ooh! Do that to start. Okay. Now these roots look like they're a little bit tight, so we want to spread them out when we repot this. And I'm going to go hit it with the hose real quick. After I get them spread out a little bit more. And I'm gonna hit them with the hose and, you know, knock off any dead stuff, any muck that's hanging out. I kind of cracked that root, but it'll be all right probably. And like kids like to say, ta-da. Okay, so that's a little bit cleaner. Can see what's going on a little bit more. I'm going to take these goggles off now that the roots are untangled. And they're not going to send soil in my face when I pull them apart, for the most part. So pull this one out. And it's growing across the bottom of the base. We want to stop that, maybe. Maybe get it to grow on the other side. Maybe not. Where is it coming out? Okay. Just got to try to pull that out. Tangled. Tangled, tangled, tangled. Okay. I'm just trying to clean this base off here. Just knock off any unwanted junk and untangle these roots any way possible. There we go. Might have to break a couple of roots here and there. It's all right. They're too tangled. Main objective is to get these roots clean. And that fat burl coming out, root burl. And I should probably cut that off. It's taken away from the tree, and maybe I can grow it. That'll be fun. Which I think I have some trees that were started like that already. I just lose track of where they are. That's why I'm trying to get it all organized and cleaned up, and part of that process is still working on these 10, 11 year old, I don't know, lose track of time, maybe 10 year old, 12 year old redwoods that I have that are super small. And I'll just put this in a larger pot for now and let it bulk up some more, let these roots flare out, fill out. This root's high. I have to cut that one off. Damaged. Screw it. Get rid of that one. And this branch down here is getting in the way. Cut that off. And we'll use these cutters, these knob cutters that I have that Eric gave me. Boom. And let's see, maybe we'll cut this big old burl going off the bottom. I don't think we need that. Just take that off. Okay. So having that off will encourage some growth to happen over here, some more root growth off the base. Get that in a bari. Oh my God, this root is out of control. I'm gonna get rid of that little piece of junk. Boom. All right, things look a little bit cleaner on this tree. Organized these roots. Much, but we'll get rid of some more of these roots. I want these roots to ramify closer to the base. Any dead looking roots? Dead looking root. A lot of these roots look dead, but they're not. They're just dark. Okay. It's about ready to be potted. Let's see if I clean it up a little bit more. This junk. Maybe some roots will grow. Get this junk off. It's old bark. Mucky soil. wrist hurts. Hey, thanks for the thumbs up. Like you guys. Appreciate it. Thanks for subscribing. And thanks for stopping by. Hey, leave a message. All right, I'm going to hit this with the hose one more time. We'll put it in the pot. And cut off some more of this dead wood. And you could probably, maybe you can hear my fountain. It's looking good. My fish are happy. Give some of that fish water to my trees. Hopefully they'll like that. We'll see how that works out this summer. All right. You know, I know the camera sucks. It's not DSL. But I'll get a DSL camera for these live recordings eventually here. And you'll be able to see these nice white or yellowish hair-like roots that are growing that are all nice and beautiful and healthy on these darker-looking roots. I'll come in with the concave cutters from American Bonsai Tools. The tool, man, that's some small writing. American Bonsai Tool Supply Company. Get that right. All right. Scrape it back a little bit more. Some of this old bark. Okay. We got some buds coming out here. Big old branches up here. What are we gonna do? Where's the front of this tree? It's got a little character to it. A little bit, that cut is on the back there, so this will be somewhere like the front, be somewhere around here. The base. Might be hard to see, sorry about that. And I can do some bending on this trunk still if I need to, but we'll put it in the pot real quick. We'll wash this pot out real fast. Soil. So I don't have the traditional soil sifters like I used to. But I have a colander that works just as good. And I'm going to sift out this fir bark mulch. Mix it with some an ultra mix, they call it, and it's got fertilizers, lava rock, sand, and coconut husk. That helps hold the water in these really dry summers. Hot summers here. A little more in the bottom. And trying to pull these roots up and out while I pot it, if I can. I'm going to fill this up. Yeah, it's hard to see. I'm sorry. Okay. Now, let's see if we can get rid of some branch work. Well, probably not. Branches we probably won't use. The problem with the tree is that it's really, really skinny. So it can't really be too tall. This is way too tall. So honestly, I mean, prefer to just cut it back even shorter and grow out little lower branches and just make it a small little bonsai redwood. Not grow it tall. So that's what I'll do. We'll just start out here. And the thing is, like, these branches are too fat anyway. But there's... So... slowly come back, ease our way in. Wow, look at all those balloons. They're gonna pop in the shed, probably. Put them in mom's room. My sister's got an excessive amount of balloons for Valentine's Day. She wants to put them in my shed. But I don't know. It might pop. But we'll see. And we want to go bilaterally, so we'll just knock off these branches bilaterally. And these will grow out fast and new. But yeah, there's 10 years of growth right there. It's really hard to tell, but that's it. Let's see if I can see the rings. This branch looks like it's only a couple of years old. All right, so what would happen will these lower branches will pop. Boom, 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 grow out. And, it'll be more ready to be a bonsai in the future. So, hey, thanks you guys for stopping by once again. This is part of the work that I have to do to maintain these trees. Here's an example of another one that's been wired, its branches all wired out. And it's got a low branch on there for the low branch lovers. And I'll repot this one too. You can see I'm just giving them more soil so they can fatten up and become bonsai. Put a little more on top there. This one's next in line. I'll water this, put it on the shelf, and see you guys next time. I trying to get this workshop done. I'm not a carpenter, so I'm having a little decision-making problems making the right decision. So I'm going to get some advice, and I'll get on it, and I'll build this workshop, and I'll have a little bit better work environment, warmer at night, lights, camera, action, all that good stuff. And let's see, what else? Looks like my phone might be lagging on the internet right now. All right, it's working. Okay, yeah, so that'll do it. Thanks for stopping by once again. Thanks for subscribing. And don't unsubscribe. Come on, man. If you're going to subscribe, stay subscribed. Stay with me forever. I'm not going nowhere unless YouTube goes somewhere. So I'll keep making bonsai. These trees will keep getting better. And if I can, I'm going to do some updates on my website soon. I know I said I'd do that from the start, but still haven't. And I know I feel bad about it, but I'll do it. And, you know, a lot of these trees that I collected, either I gave away or didn't make it, or in Louisiana or somewhere else, but I still have a couple. So we'll do some updates and move forward. Keep making your art. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. It's the most important thing to you. It's the most important thing to me, to make these trees, do whatever it takes to do that. So again, go bonsai. How do I get out of here? I see the numbers popping. It's popping off right now. I got to take a break. I got to stop. Maybe I'll be back in a little while. Peace.